praise God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this beautiful day. It is the day that you have made, God, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for health. We thank you that our minds are in one piece, that we are in the right place, mighty God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you that we have the thoughts, Lord God, to come before you, Lord Jesus, as we gather together on the plug to fellowship, mighty God. We invite you in our midst, and Lord, we pray that you will prepare our hearts for whatever word you have for us this morning. Mighty God, we receive it, Lord God, and we pray that it will be applied to our hearts, applied to our lives, mighty God, and that we, Lord God, will play our part in advancing your kingdom here on earth. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Stay with me.
So our scripture for this morning, let me just turn this down. Our scripture for this morning will be coming to us from 1 Peter 5 and verse 7. And it says, be sober, this is the King James Version, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Another version says, be watchful and be vigilant. Praise God. 1 Peter 5 verse 8. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Praise God. This is not a scripture that is new to us. We have heard this over and over, but I just believe that in this season, this scripture is even more relevant. It's more important to us at this point in time. So what I'm about to do, I'm going to define what these terms mean. What does it mean to be watchful, to be vigilant, to be sober, right? So to be watchful means observing someone or something closely, to be alert and to be vigilant. That's what watchful means, observing someone closely, someone or something closely, to be alert and to be vigilant. Now, vigilant means keeping careful watch for possible dangers or difficulties. Keeping careful watch for possible dangers or difficulties. And sober, we know to mean that you are not intoxicated, right? Because when you're intoxicated, you're not alert, right? You have a slow reaction time. It takes a while for you to register that something is wrong. Even if you are wounded and you are intoxicated, it takes you a while to realize that there is a wound there. It takes you a while to feel the pain that is coming from that wound. And so to be sober is characterized by reason, sanity, self-control, showing mental and emotional balance, right? So that's what the writer is saying to us. Peter is saying to us that we need to be characterized by reason, we need self-control, we need to be showing mental and emotional balance, right? And we need to be keeping careful watch for possible dangers or difficulties, and we need to be observing closely at this point in time, in this season. Look around us. Praise God. We need to be in this state of mind. We need to be watchful, sober, and vigilant in this season so that we can discern the time. Bless the Lord, Pastor Monica. Praise God. So that we can discern the time, where we are, what is happening, and what we are meant to do in a time like this. Praise God. We have been called like Queen Esther for such a time as this. Praise God. And in our vigilance, in our sobriety, in our watchfulness, we need to be asking God, God, what is our role in this season? How are we called for such a time as this? What do you need for me to do? Praise God. Moving further along in this scripture, it says, because your enemy, so be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Greetings, Lady Theresa. Seeking whom he may devour. I want to talk about this. I want to talk about this for a while. The word of God says he is roaring about, walking about as a lion, as a roaring lion. I want to talk a little bit about the lion this morning, because when we've heard teachings about the lion and we hear all the glorious things about a lion and all of that, but I want to talk about the fact that the devil is walking around like a roaring lion. What does that even mean? What's going on here? Well, we're going to be looking, praise God, at the lion, at the traits of the lion, and how the devil is impersonating a lion in our lives this morning. Praise God. So what do we know about lions? Lions are brave, and they're considered the king of the jungle or the king of beasts. Lions are not the strongest. They are certainly not the biggest, but when they step into a place, everybody fears them because of the mindset that they have. So when the word of God says that the devil is walking around as a roaring lion, he's pretty much commanding our respect. He's trying to intimidate us. He wants us to be afraid of him, to say that, hey, he is all that plus a bag of chips. Praise God. Lions are feared by animals, both big and small. Lions that are animals that are stronger and animals that are weaker than them. They are just feared right across the board. So the enemy is parading himself around like a lion. Why? Because he wants us to fear him. He wants us, you know, to just move out of his way. He wants us to bow to him, to say, hey, Mr. Lion, Mr. Devil, we fear you and all of that. Praise God. Hallelujah. But that's not what we are supposed to do. Praise God. We are not supposed to be afraid of the enemy, right? Lions are known to take down animals as big as elephants, as big as giraffe. Praise God. Hallelujah. Because these, you know, listen, an elephant is so much bigger than a lion. It's ridiculous. By one step on a lion, the elephant can kill that lion. Praise God. But when the lion is coming, the elephant runs. Praise God. Why? Because of the presence that the lion commands. Praise God. We are elephants. We are bigger. We are stronger than the enemy. Not by might, not by strength, not by power, but by the Spirit of God that dwells in us, positions us as elephants in comparison to a lion. We are stronger. We ought to be fiercer than the lion. And so we ought not to be afraid. Praise God. Hallelujah. We ought not to be afraid of this lion that is roaring about, moving about, right? Seeking to devour us, all of us. Praise God. It also says that a lion attacks the elephants when they are either young or when they are either sick. So they're either young or they're either sick. Praise God. That's when they attack them by themselves. And so if you ever notice that your attacks come even stronger when you are not well, when you're not physically well, when you're not emotionally well, the enemy seems to attack you even more. I said before that this enemy of ours, the devil, he is an unfair fighter. Praise God. He's an unfair opponent. He knows when to strike, and he knows how to strike that it matters, that we feel it. Praise God. And so he is there. He is lurking. He is waiting on you, waiting until you are sick, waiting, praise God, until you sleep, waiting. Hallelujah. Praise God. The lion lurks around in the bushes. They sit there. They will sit there for hours watching their prey. Praise God. If there is a herd of animals, they sit there and they watch and they wait until the herd moves and exposes one, a young one or even a sick one. Praise God. And then he strikes. And that is why it is so important, people of God, that we stick together. Praise God. That is why it's so important that we guard each other. Those who are weak, those who are wounded. Praise God. That's the way that we're going to overcome the enemy when we stick together. It's easier for the enemy to attack you one away than it is for him to attack all of us here on the plug this morning. Why? Because when we all turn against him, he is in over his head. Praise God. And that is why the word of God says that united we stand, but divided we will fall. Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. Pastor Patrice, welcome, welcome, welcome. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, lions proclaim their territory by roaring. And so when the word of God says the devil as a roaring lion walketh about, what he's doing, he is proclaiming his territory. He's letting you know, hey, I'm here, I'm in the place, and this is where I belong, and you are subjected to me because I run things, right? That's what the enemy wants us to think when he comes around and roar. You can probably identify, you have some roaring lions in your workplace, you have some roaring lions in your community, some roaring lions around you, and when they come in, there is just so much chaos, and they just feel like they own everything, and they show that they pretend. Let me just say, they pretend like they own everything. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's the enemy trying to mark his territory wherever he goes. But I want to know if there are some Joshuas on here this morning. Praise God, because the word of God said to Joshua that everywhere his foot tread belongs to him. Praise God, which means that it doesn't matter which roaring lion there is around you, wherever your foot tread, you are to command that atmosphere, you are to command that territory. Praise God. So it doesn't matter who is rearing up their heads at work, at home, in, you know, in the community, or wherever you go. Praise God, because of who you are and who you have dwelling in you. Praise God, you ought to own that territory. Lions are very territorial. Hallelujah. And they make it known with their roars. They make it known with their pees, right? They will walk around and they will pee everywhere. Hallelujah. Pee everywhere, and the stench will let another lion know, or even other predators know that, hey, a lion is here and I am the owner. Hallelujah. Some of your workplaces are so stink with those stenches coming from these roaring lions. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But I want us, people of God, to be rising up, praise God, into these places and letting the enemy know that I am in charge. Let me tell you something about me. You all see me. I'm very simple. I am very simple. I'm very calm. But I have this mentality. When I step into a place, I command that place. I do not care who is in charge. When I step in, I am in charge. Whatever spiritual turf I step on, that's mine. I don't care which territorial demon owned that place, because when I tread upon a place, I tread with the Spirit of God. And that's what the Lord says. He says that everywhere I step belongs to me, and every spirit must bow to the Spirit in me. Praise God. And that's how I always look at things. That's how, people of God, we need to operate. When you step into your workplace, every other spirit that is operating needs to bow to the Spirit of God that is in you. You're having problems in your home. When you step into that place, every spirit of conflict and confusion, hallelujah, needs to bow to you. And when the enemy roars at you, praise God, hallelujah, I feel like I am jumping ahead. The enemy is nothing but a copycat, because ultimately that is what a lion is. A lion is just a big cat. Praise God, hallelujah. They might be be fierce, but they are a cat. Hallelujah. And the devil is a copycat. He's walking around like a roaring lion, copying the lion of the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. Because Jesus is the lion. Hallelujah. The enemy is impersonating the lion of the tribe of Judah. And so we ought not to be afraid of him, because we belong to that lion. Hallelujah. King Jesus, he is who we belong to. Glory be to God. And so the enemy is over here trying to get you intimidated, you being afraid of him like he is the lion. Praise God. But he's just roaring as a lion, because that he is not. Glory be to God. You, hallelujah, serve the lion of the tribe of Judah. Praise the name of Jesus. And so we ought to walk in that knowledge. We ought to walk in that authority. Praise God. Hallelujah. The word of God says, at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue must confess that he is Lord. Praise God. And when you step in to a location, when you step into any situation, praise God, you're not stepping in by yourself. You are stepping in with the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. With, hallelujah, the lion of the tribe of Judah. Praise the name of Jesus. And when the enemy, who is pretending to be a lion, sees us walking in with the real lion, praise God, whatever marking of territory that he was doing, he has to stop and he has to flee. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Ooh, I got all excited just now. Yes, we are with the lion of the tribe of Judah. And so the enemy is there walking around, and he's prowling and he's roaring and he's peeing everywhere, marking his territory. Praise God. But when we step in, hallelujah, we ought to show him that, hey, this is not your territory anymore. I am here, and this belongs to the lion of the tribe of Judah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lions have terrific night vision. If you ever notice, warfare heightens at night. You go to your bed. I know there are times when I go to my bed and I wake up just as tired. I'm fighting, I'm running, I'm kicking, I'm doing all manner of things. I'm deep into warfare, and that's because the enemy likes to war at night when he knows that it's a disadvantage to his prey. Praise God. Because we don't have excellent night vision. Praise God. We see better in the day. And so the enemy knows this, and so he comes at night. And that's why it's so important for us to watch throughout the night. Praise God. To be praying. You know, there are some persons that you shake them at night and you touch them and they turn around speaking in tongues, or they turn around praying. Praise God. Because they are praying all throughout the night. They're watching all throughout the night. And if that is not you, that's something to be coveted. That's something to ask the Lord for. Lord, help me to war throughout the night, to pray all night, to be warring even in my sleep. One of my prayers that I pray is that the Lord will help me, praise God, to be alert in my dreams, to conquer the enemy. Praise God. Because the enemy cannot conquer me throughout the day, and so he attacks me in my dreams. Praise God. And sometimes I don't even know what happened in my dreams until I wake up. And so a constant prayer of mine is that, Lord, I'm asking you to help me to be alert in my dreams just as much as I am throughout the day, so that I'm able to conquer every attack of the enemy that comes to me in my sleep. Praise the name of Jesus. And then the last point I'm bringing forth with the lion and how he operates is that he will leap on his prey, and the first place he attacks is the neck of the prey. He's attacking the neck, and he will bite the neck of his prey until the animal has been strangled. Praise God. Have you ever felt like you cannot breathe? Like you are slowly dying, you're losing air. The situation is so rough, it's so strong that you are barely able to survive. You can't even catch a breath. That is the attack of the roaring lion upon your life. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But people of God, when we know how the enemy operates, when we know what he's up to, I don't think it is by accident that the apostle Peter actually used this lion as an example when he says the devil is moving around like a roaring lion. No, he had a reason behind using that example. Praise God. Hallelujah. Because he knows how the lion operates, and we now know how the lion operates, which means that we are now equipped to be more vigilant. We are now equipped to be more watchful. Why? Because we know what we are looking for. Praise God. If you are searching for something and you don't know what it is, it will take you hours to search, and someone else will come along and say, what are you looking for? You say, oh, I'm looking for this pin, and they will walk right up to the pin and they will pick it up on your life. But I searched there 5 times. Why? Because you didn't know what you were looking for. So now that you know what you are looking for, praise God, it becomes easier for you to be watchful. It becomes easier for you to discern what the enemy is up to. Praise God. And so when you see the roaring, praise God, when you smell the stench, when you see the attacks coming in, you know that it's the lion, and you know that you are greater, for greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Praise God. Hallelujah. More are they that are with you than they that are against you. And the enemy knows these truths. Praise God. He knows these truths. But what he wants to do, praise God, is to make sure that we do not know. That's why the word of God says his people perish for a lack of knowledge. And if the enemy can keep us in the dark, guess what? He has conquered us. Praise the name of Jesus. And that is why the word of God says, study to show yourself approved. We have to study the word of God. We have to study our opponent, because the enemy, since the foundation of time, has been studying every single human that has walked this earth. So he's an expert on humans. He doesn't even need to know you personally, Lady Teresa. He just needs to know that you have these certain patterns that classifies you into this group of people. And then he knows that I have this certain pattern that classifies me into a group of people. And so he has his tactics to deal with this group and his tactics to deal with that group. And so he comes at us and he attacks us, praise God, because he knows our patterns. We, people of God, need to know the pattern of the enemy. Praise God. You cannot fight an opponent that you do not know. Hallelujah. You will be conquered. Praise the name of Jesus. And so in being watchful, in being vigilant, praise God, we have to know who we are up against. We have to know what we are up against, and we have to be a step ahead of him, and we don't have to worry. Praise God. Hallelujah. Because we serve a strategic God. Hallelujah. That is why, as I said before, he wants us in that secret place. He wants us, hallelujah, into his secret chambers to show us what the enemy is about to do, and to remind us, hey, that guess what? Listen, because you are my child, wherever you set your foot on, that is your territory. Hallelujah. Do not be afraid. He says that in the word of God 365 times. The enemy's roar, hallelujah, is to intimidate you, to make you afraid, for you to run, so that he can become the true owner of the territory. Let me say that, the true owner of the territory, because once you are there, the territory belongs to you and God. And so he roars to scare you off so that he can claim that territory for real, real, right? Because it was never his to begin with. It belongs to you. So I don't know in what capacity this word is going to apply to your life this morning, whether it's going to be at work, whether it's going to be at home, whether it's going to be in your community or any space at all that you are in. I just want to encourage you this morning that you are not to be afraid of the roaring lion, the devil who is parading as a roaring lion, because you serve the lion of the tribe of Judah, and he is the undefeated champion. Praise God. Like, we're on the winning team, people of God. What are we afraid of? Once we stay tucked into his bosom, we will always be the winners. Hallelujah. And so we do not have to be afraid of the enemy. Hallelujah. Not afraid of the terror by day, the arrow by night. Praise God. I always mix that up. Praise the name of Jesus. Right? We do not have to be afraid of anything that the enemy comes with. So each time you hear 1 Peter 5 verse 8 that talks about the devil walking around as a roaring lion, remember that we belong to the clan of the lion of the tribe of Judah, and he is the undefeated champion. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your word this morning. Lord, we are grateful for this reminder. Lord, we needed this morning, hallelujah, because, Lord, we've been feeling defeated, we've been feeling down, we've been feeling out, but God, you have reminded us this morning, hallelujah, that we, hallelujah, are on the winning team, God, and when the enemy comes in, praise God, we can just know that you, Holy Spirit, will raise up a standard against him, mighty God. We pray this morning that this word, Lord God, we will hide it in our hearts, Lord God, and that we will come back to it every time we come upon a situation that requires it. Lord, I pray that you will bless the Plug family, bless our new viewers, mighty God, bless those who have been riding with us for all of these months, God, bless the women who minister on this platform, mighty God, and our new addition, bless her, God, especially this morning. Father, have your way, mighty God, and I pray that you will enlarge our territory so that we can reach more with the gospel, we can reach more with the word, Lord God, as we all together, mighty God, as a unit, seek, Lord God, to expand your kingdom, hallelujah, seek to bring forth, Lord God, your agenda on this earth as it is in heaven. Have your way in our lives this morning, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you, people of God. God keep you and make his face to shine down on you. You are blessed, and everything about you is blessed. Everyone connected to you are blessed because you are blessed. Praise the name of Jesus. So join